Good afternoon, everybody. Before starting my lecture, I would like to thank Dr. Srinivas sir and Dr. Pradeep sir for giving me opportunity. Today, my talk on pediatric vertigo differential diagnosis. Why this topic is important? Because in most of the diseases routinely seen in adult are different from pediatrics. Pediatric disease patients. 8% of children had a sometimes affected by vertigo dizziness or balance problem. Congenital vestibular failure is found in 10 to 20% of infants with congenital deafness. Diagnosis without objective testing is difficult because young children rarely obey the instructions. Vestibular disturbance in these children gradually disappear as they grow up because of compensatory mechanism of CNS. Children's balance system are highly plastic, so rehabilitation and balance function training is very effective than adult. Signs and symptoms of dizziness in children. Child may not able to articulate all complaints, frightening, clutching caretakers, clumsiness, sudden falls or tipping over, delayed motor function seen in children, loss of postural control, difficulty with ambulating in dark, abnormal movements or behavior seen, infants may lie down against side of crib with eyes closed, child not want to be moved. Differential diagnosis. Three types, peripheral, central and others. Peripheral types most commonly seen are otitis media, BPVOC, benign paroxysmal vertigo of childhood, vestibular neuronitis, labyrinthitis, Meniere's disease, perilymph fistula, BPPV. Central types, migraine-related vertigo, most common in children, stroke, seizure, epilepsy, head injury, CNS infection, tumor, demyelinating disease, hydrocephalus. Others are psychogenic, again most common in children, unknown origin of vertigo, familial ataxia, orthostatic hypotension, hypoglycemia. Vertigo, most common conditions seen in children. Orange color written conditions are most commonly seen in my practice. Migraine, psychogenic vertigo, BPVOC, otitis media, cholestatoma, mastoiditis, vestibular neuronitis, labyrinthitis. Adverse effect of medications, motion sickness, paroxysmal torticollis of infancy, pseudo-vertigo like hypoglycemia, hypoxia, hypoperfusion. Vertigo, life-threatening conditions, head injury, CNS infection, CNS infarction, intracranial tumor, stroke, seizure, epilepsy, drug overdose and poison. Other conditions are very rarely seen in children, BPPV, Meniere's disease, perilymph fistula, multiple sclerosis, vestibulopathy, Ramsden syndrome, vertigo of unknown origin, congenital anomalies commonly seen are Chiari malformation, encephalocele, cerebellar aplasia, hypoplasia. Now I will talk one by one disease. First is benign paroxysmal vertigo of childhood. It is considered to be migraine variant or precursor of migraine. What is the age of onset? It generally onset around the age of the 4 years, but it may be around the 5 to 10 years. After onset, it gradually increase in frequency and day by day increase in frequency and gradually decreasing in severity, and it usually cure at the age of 10 years. Characteristic. What is the type of vertigo seen in this patient? Characteristic are sudden onset of vertigo, recurrent in nature, usually lasts for few minutes, it's self-limiting in few minutes. It is always associated with sweating, but nausea, vomiting, nystagmus is very rarely seen. Child is frightened, typically clutches an adult until attack ceases. After attack, child play like nothing had happened. Diagnosis. Diagnosis based on typical history, because all otoneurological examination and radiological examinations are normal in this type of patients. Diagnose only after exclusion of all routine causes of vertigo. Family history of migraine is usually present. Usually family history of migraine present in mother. Child later develop typical migraine. Diagnostic criteria. There are 4 diagnostic criteria. Criteria A. at least 5 attacks follows B criteria. Criteria B, multiple episodes of severe vertigo occurring without warning, spontaneously resolving after few minutes to hours. C, normal neurological examination, audiometric function and vestibular function in between the attacks, normal EEG. Treatment, usually no treatment because it's self-limiting condition, only counseling of child and parents help. Explain the parents about the benign course of BPVOC. Differential diagnosis, mistaken for seizures. EEG is usually normal and no altered consciousness in BPVOC. Spontaneously resolve after 2 to 3 years of onset. It distinct from BPPV. BPVOC not provoked by any particular head position or movement, while as we know, BPPV short attacks of vertigo in certain positional movement, and Dix-Hallpike manner is the diagnostic test for BPPV. Now again, most common conditions seen in children as well as in adult, migraine. Up to 19% of children have a vertiginous symptom during aura of migraine. No specific biological marker exists for migraine-related vertigo and is diagnosed only on the basis of history. History is very important in migraine patients. Vertigo may or may not associated with headache, aura, photophobia, phonophobia is present. Vertigo usually associated with head movements. Tinnitus may be present because of inner ear vessel spasm. And there is a history of repeated attacks, strong positive family history of migraine, past history of motion sickness seen in few patients, and normal neurological examination. Strange history in migraine patients. I observe in my practice there are different types of complaint in migraine patients, from transient vertigo while head movement to vertigo lasts for few minutes to hours, history of first giddiness then sudden fall down but without unconsciousness, usually rotatory in nature most of time, sometimes blackening is also present, headache is present in 60% of patients. There is a one dictum: if you couldn't reach the exact diagnosis and if you rule out other CNS related vertigo, then give anti-migraine trial. I really in my routine practice succeed in more than 50% patient of such undiagnosed patient with anti-migraine trial. Romberg test, swaying may be present. Treatments are trial of anti-migraine medicines, lifestyle modification and dietary changes. Migraine variants and complicated migraine. The neurological disturbances can sometimes mimic stroke, seizure, movement disorders and other diseases. These manifestation of migraine in childhood are called migraine variants or complicated migraine. Migraine variants are precursor of or associated with migraine. 5-9 non-migraine variants are BPVOC, cyclic vomiting, infantile torticollis, acephalic migraine and acute confusional migraine. Complicated migraine. Headache is almost always present in complicated migraine. The known forms are ophthalmoplegic migraine, retinal migraine, hemiplegic migraine, basilary artery migraine. In complicated migraine patients, there are higher chances of risk of developing strokes in future. Now, infantile torticollis, benign paroxysmal torticollis. Age of onset of infantile torticollis is around the age of 3 to 8 months of age and it usually disappears at the age of 2 years. Characteristics: head inclines is seen associated with nausea, vomiting, pallor and agitations, and it lasts for hours to days. Mechanism: what is mechanism? Head inclination is seen towards the slow phase of nystagmus in infants. Treatment: usually no treatment, only reassurance. It may be early onset of variants of basilar migraine. It differs from epilepsy in that consciousness is clear in BPV. Seizure: sudden onset of vertigo with or without nausea, vomiting, headache, followed by period of altered consciousness. Here, altered consciousness word is very important in seizure. There must be altered consciousness in seizure. Any episodes of unexplained fall down, first possibility considered to be seizure in children. Any staring look, cessation of eye contact, may or may not associated with fall down, but cessation of motor activity suggestive of seizure in children. Incontinence of urine or stool in unexplained fall down in children is also suggestive of seizure. Electroencephalogram usually abnormal. Difference between seizure and complicated migraine. In complicated migraine, patient having a history of typical migraine attacks like headache, photophobia, phonophobia. In complicated migraine, evolution of symptoms and signs slower than seizure. In complicated migraine, patients has a memory of event, while in seizure, patient has no memory of event. In complicated migraine, nausea, vomiting more common. Psychological vertigo, again most common in children. Underlying depressive disorder is present. Most common psychological factor found to be school related. Other factors are familial dysfunction, parental psychopathology, child sex abuse. Diagnosis from history, and child can easily play a balance game in OPD while during examination. Early psychiatric consultation is required. Vestibular neuronitis, almost same as in adult. Difference is that prognosis is better than in adult and faster recovery of vestibular ocular reflex defect, indicating faster recovery of nystagmus. Otitis media related vertigo. Otitis media and otitis media with effusion. In otitis media, mechanism still remain obscure, while in otitis media with effusion, postural instability during otitis media with effusion is because of pressure changes in middle ear and serous labyrinthitis. Balance function usually become normal after clear of fluid in the middle ear by medicines or by grommet. Post-traumatic vertigo in children. Two types, primary disorders and secondary disorders. Primary disorders are BPPV, usually in post-traumatic multi-canal, labyrinthine concussion, perilymphatic fistula, central vestibular disorders. Secondary disorders are delayed endolymphatic high drops, cervicogenic vertigo, otolithic disorders. Underlying disorders in post-traumatic vertigo are identified and treated accordingly. Meniere syndrome. 100 times less frequent than in adult because Meniere's disease is a disease of damaged inner ear. In damaged inner ear, chances are increased with age. That's why it's less common in children. Uncommon in less than 10 years, vertigo with triad of symptoms like hearing loss, tinnitus, heaviness of ear, but not typical as seen in adult, so require years of follow-up. BPPV, again very less in children because cupular deposits are phenomenon of aging vestibular labyrinth. Ocular disorders, usually we all in routine practice forget ocular disorders. Convergence insufficiency or latent strabismus can cause vertigo. Refractive errors such as hyperopia, myopia, astigmatism can cause vertigo. Trigger factors are frequent use of television, mobile or computers in children. Recover with simple ophthalmic treatments. When everything including vestibular test normal, remember ophthalmic problem. In congenital amblyopia, shuffling walk due to inability to perceive steps because of difficulty in judging the distance and shaking of head to ease nystagmus. Pseudovertigo. These are all list of pseudovertigo: arrhythmia, anemia, anxiety, depression, heat illness, hyperventilation, hypoglycemia, orthostatic hypotension, poisoning or medicine side effects, pre-syncope, visual disturbance. Now I will talk about congenital vestibular impairment. Milestones of motor developments are holding up heads 3 to 4 months of age, sitting up at 7 months of age, standing with support at 9 months of age, walking with support at 11 months of age, standing without support at 12 months of age, and walking without support 13 to 14 months of age. What are the common causes of congenital impairment of balance function? These are cytomegalovirus infection in prenatal periods, Mondini's type of dysplasia in which bag shape otolith and absence of semicircular canal seen, Arnold-Chiari malformations, encephalocele, cerebral aplasia, hypoplasia, genetic syndromes like Paediatric syndrome, Usher syndrome, in which dilated vestibular aqueduct is seen. Congenital vestibular impairment or loss. Control of head is delayed and head usually flop backwards while infant in sitting positions. Lower muscle tone, abnormality in postural reflex and loss of labyrinthine writing reflex, but this reflex recovery become faster by other routes like vision and non-labyrinthine reflex route. Gross motor developments are delayed. Symptoms include clumsiness, poor handwriting, slow in action, and difficulty in maintaining balance. Arnold-Chiari malformation, most congenital anomaly, disease of magnovertebral junctions. Chiari 2 is most common type. Cerebellum protrude downward through foramen magnum, intrude into the cervical vertebra and compress the pons and medulla. Diagnosis only by MRI. Patient having a cerebellar disequilibrium, gaze nystagmus and downbeating nystagmus is most common in Arnold-Chiari malformation. Congenital oculomotor apraxia. What is apraxia? Apraxia means condition in which instructed voluntarily movement is not executed normally. When gazing or fixing eyes on an object, head is moved too far and overshoot the target. When head is rotated, the eyes remain deviated to side opposite to rotation. Abnormality seen in visual stimulators like gaze, eye tracking and optokinetics. Last slide. Cochlear implantation and vestibular problems. Most of the patients reveal only weak, slow phase of nystagmus to the operated side or opposite side, but it disappear within 10 days. But in few patients, severe vertigo and large paretic nystagmus because of influence of electrode insertion, which produces similar effect as inner ear destructions. Infants with cochlear implants had a head tilt to the operated side and balance dysfunction, but it disappear within 1 week. Thank you.